time moves slowly in Woodchurch. The trees are always green and no one seems to age. This place feels safe, but is it too safe? No one gets injured and we have no police. Crimes don't happen. No one steals or kills or even gets angry. It's like we're living in a bubble that can be popped at any moment. I seem to be the only one who notices, though. Well, the only one except my best friend Jimmy. He can see it too. He can see the lies. I know what you're thinking. I'm paranoid. Well, I'm not. I'm as sane as you. Me and Jimmy know that there has to be some flaw here. Something to put a dent in this perfectly smooth reality that we live in. But honestly, this can't be reality because reality isn't perfect. It's got dents and scratches like an old car. So we decided to get out. To leave Woodchurch forever. As we set off walking down the smooth tarmac towards my house, I glance left and right at the pristine houses with their freshly mown lawns and white picket fences. My house comes into view as we reach the top of Derma Hill, sitting there as symmetrical as all the other houses. I walk through the light blue front door only to be intercepted by my mother before I could reach the stairs. And where are you and Jimmy running off to this time, Rosa? She asked me with a happy, yet distantly cold-hearted smile. We're just off to the lake to see the cattle spine fish, I say with what I hope is a good, I don't care what you think, smile. Well, okay, but be back by 4 at the latest, Mother says with a strained voice. Me and Jimmy head back outside, not bothering to go up to my room and get our supplies. We head towards Crystal Lake with fake smiles plastered across our faces. The plan was simple. I would go into the lake first and Jimmy would keep my head underwater. If this wasn't reality, then I would wake up somewhere else. If this was reality, then I didn't want to live here anyway. As we got closer to the lake, I began to wonder what world I might wake up in. The lake looked beautiful in the afternoon sun, and I realised that this was the only thing I would miss. I got down on my knees and let him push my head down into the crisp blue water. Poor Jimmy, having to kill your best friend couldn't exactly be fun. I felt the air being sucked from my lungs and I felt my body slip away in the dark abyss of death. Moments later I woke with a gasp to find myself encased in an egg-like dome, with wires attached to my head and the sound of alarms. Hundreds of domes filled the room. This was reality, and reality looked bad.